Script for a Jester's Tear is the debut album by the progressive rock band Marillion. I hope I'm saying that right, you know, because I've said it wrong numerous times over the... Well, I believe in the stream, but let's not go into that. Yeah, debut record by them. This came out in 1983. It's neo-progressive rock. And I believe this is requested by Chloe Johnson. I'm not sure, because, well, it's not really a while ago, but it has been like a week or so. And I tend to be very forgetful, so there we go. So I think it's Chloe Johnson. If it's not, correct yourself or, you know, comment on the video that you did it. So there we go. We have, I believe, 6 songs from there. The record is 46 minutes long. This was kind of a neo-progressive rock record. I'm not sure if the band still has that label, you know, the neo shit. I'm not sure. But everybody that has talked about Marillion so far has talked about them positively, you know, that they are a very great modern progressive rock. Well, not really modern, but kind of the second wave of progressive rock, I believe. You have like, I'm not sure how many waves you have, but they are, you know, they are kind of a revival band since this was the early 80s. And prog was mostly very, you know, very alive and breeding in the 70s. So this was one of the records that kind of, you know, revived the whole thing. Which a lot of people are thankful for Marillion. I believe there are always people out there like that, you know, that they think that Marillion is not real prog. But I've listened to this record and they definitely are real prog, you know. If I know my progressive rock bands, then Marillion is surely another one of them. And one of my favorites so far, you know, because their discography is very consistent. A lot of great records, what I've read. You know, I haven't heard them yet, but this one was really good. We have 6 songs overall, and the title track Script for a Jester's Tear is the first one. All of these tracks are, most of them are 8 minutes long, 4 out of the 6 ones. Second one is 5 minutes long, which was the single, I believe. And we also have a 7-minute track, which are arguably the most catchy ones. But the title track is very catchy as well, has a lot of these very revival-ish prog elements to it. It sounds very synth heavy, it sounds very, you know, just prog in general, very wizardly, very nerdy as well. So you can definitely hear that this band is inspired by, you know, a Yes, a King Crimson, and you know, Genesis, just, you know, your typical prog bands. And Marillion basically took you know, the starting, the platform for that, and kind of built off of that, of course. Because you gotta have, of course, some building blocks to really, you know, make a career out of something. You know, because every artist has to have an influence, otherwise they can't really make music, I guess. Or I guess that's kind of true, you know, that is kind of the thing. So Marillion did need to have some inspiration, you know, to later sound original as they did. But yeah, that's pretty much, you know, the story for every band, so there we go. Very great song, a great title track, starts the record out perfectly. Shows, you know, what is going to come while still, you know, being still mystique and not revealing everything. Kind of a trailer-ish song, kind of a really long-ass trailer, but a great trailer at that. He Knows You Know is the biggest single of this release, I believe. It's 5 minutes long, so it has a perfect, you know, radio length. Well, it's not perfect, 3.5 minutes would be, but 5 minutes still, you know, still manages to be a single, which is pretty impressive, you know, for prog in general. But yeah, this is a very catchy song as well. It has a lot of these very poppy elements to it, so Marillion proves that they have, you know, kind of a catchy, kind of a melodic side to them as well. Yeah, but, you know, progressive rock has to be melodic, otherwise you're being known as math, or, you know, you're not really prog. So, yeah, this band, or the band has that, you know, a lot, I would say. So this song is very catchy. It is, you know, it was a breakthrough track for the band. And I really enjoyed it. It was a great follow-up track to Script for Jesters, fucking up Jesters there. You know, the band proves here that they're not, you know, fully, kind of a fully nerdy prog band, but they have the singles as well, which I love, you know, if you have that combination together. You're really the version, my book. Then we have The Web, which is kind of a sleeper song. It is the longest song of the record. It's 8 minutes and 48 seconds. This is another great track at Close Outside 1. Yeah, and this track is overall very proggy. It sounds kind of dark as well. I'm not sure what they're talking about, you know, with The Web. Maybe, you know, the internet, or maybe spider-web or something, I don't know, but... you know, it can be either way, and this song just sounds epic. It has an epic nature to it, so the band is just basically proving, you know, we can be catchy and ominous at the same time. With He Knows You Know, they prove that they are catchy, and with The Web, they prove that they can be a really creepy band, which is not per se a bad thing. It only adds to the diversity of the record, I would say. It's a very long song, but it doesn't drag on. We have some, you know, recurring themes coming from the first two songs on The Web, which, you know, basically perfectly encapsulates those first two songs and makes an, in my opinion, even better song. So The Web is, in my opinion, so far the best song. Very great track, and what a way to close this out one, for sure. Then we have Garden Party, which is the second shortest song of this record, which is 7 minutes, which should say that they are a progressive rock band, or prog in general. That, you know, that's just, you will have to agree with, you will have to agree that, fucking hell. But Garden Party, you know, very catchy song. It is kind of like He Knows You Know, but then more progressive and more kind of, it sounds kind of, you know, summer-ish. It sounds very melodic, very mellow as well, you know, a garden party. It is kind of a, you know, relaxing title, I would say. Just having, you know, kind of a really relaxed party in your garden or something. Which, you know, I genuinely, if you would ask me, you know, gets me relaxed, so probably the band as well. Yeah, this song is just mostly kind of adventurous. It sounds kind of really adventurous. It sounds very wild, very relaxed as well. So this song is a mixed bag of emotions, and that's definitely how I feel towards the song. You know, not that I'm mixed about the song, but I'm genuinely, I've a mixed mixed amount of feelings. You know, sadness, happiness, you know, passionate, if you can call it an emotion, but, you know, positive emotions, stuff like that. Although, you know, sadness as in good, fucking hell, happy tears, I guess, but... You know what I mean. You know, this song gets me happy, and, you know, a lot of other feelings, because it sounds very, just very happy, just very, you know, emotional. Reminds me of a lot of good times, and, yeah, the song overall was, I believe, another single for the band. Yeah, and deservingly so, because it's a great song. Then we have Chelsea Monday, which... is kind of, you know, more of the staple records of the record. These last two songs are still really good, in my opinion. They're both 8 minutes, but I think that they mostly repeat what already has been done on the record, with Chelsea Monday kind of being a Script for Jesters there part 2, in my opinion. And this song is definitely good. It definitely, you know, it deserved the 8 minute mark, but I think that it could have used a little bit more originality to really be more different than the other songs. And then we have Forgotten Sons, which kind of is the sad, the mellow, dreary song, which kind of is the part two of The Web. And this side two kind of repeats side one, but, you know, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. And, you know, that is definitely a useful saying for some bands that are really repetitive. But, you know, for prog it can be as well, because, you know, if your formula, you know, is perfect or near flawless, then, you know, why change it? And side 2 is basically a side 1, you know, mimic, a copy of side 1, But I still think that Side 2 manages to fill up the gap very nicely, and Forgotten Sons is a very sad, mellow, depressing prog rock song, which ends the record very, sadly, but, you know, surely, a very somber tone. Not per se a happy ending, but definitely a very haunting, melodic, and very, you know, addictive note that, you know, makes you keep spinning the record over and over again. Or, you know, playing, streaming, whatever your, you know, preferences in music playing, but there we go. This is the record, Script for Justice Tear by Marillion. Very great debut record. I would say that Side 1 was basically flawless. I love Garden Party. My only thing that the last two songs are kind of iffy for me. Still pretty good, but kind of a continuation of the first, of the earlier songs. And you know what they say, you know, can be the original. For most of the time that is true, so there we go. But this record was still really great, although, I thought that Side 2 was a little bit weaker, but still really good. So I'm gonna give this record an 8.8 out of 10. Let me know what you think about Script for Justice Tear by Marillion. Very great progressive rock album, neo-progressive rock, whatever you want to call this thing. Very good record by a very great band, so there we go. And if you guys want me to check out more Marillion records, then I'm gonna do that. And if you guys are not gonna do that, I'm gonna scope them out for myself, because Marillion is a really great band, and yeah, you know, if I'm gonna listen more to them, I will eventually love this band, which I already kind of do because, you know, of the reception and because of, you know, all the positive reactions that people give them. So they have to be really great, and you know, this record was really great, so the hype is real, I guess. Let me know what you think about this record. Let me know what you think about Marillion. Let me know if you want to do more records by them, because I will definitely do, because they are a very great band. So there we go. Hope you have enjoyed this video. Like this video, subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one. Let me know what you think about this record in the comments down below, and I will see you guys in the next video. God bless, safe, take care, and peace.